getting two sets of Nigerians today. Those who are having a virtuous circle, those who have are having more. Those who don't have are trapped. And I want to link this about breaking this, that when I was growing up, the children of the rich and the poor, and I'm sure it's the same for most of you, attended the same schools, taught by the same teachers. So if the children of the poor were brilliant enough, they had a chance of climbing out of the loop. Is that what happened? Today, the children of the middle and upper class are in elite private schools in Nigeria and abroad. The children of the poor are condemned in the very low level, poorly funded, poorly resourced public schools where they receive very little learning going on. What happens is that the children of the poor, therefore, end up with little or no education. They end up on the wrong side of society, and therefore their own children end up in the same process, and poverty has therefore become a dynasty. The parents are poor, and their children in all likelihood end up being poor. For you to break out of this, and you add to that the population explosion, especially in the frontline states. You add the fact that agriculture will not be a means of livelihood sustainably in the longer term. As the economy modernizes, you'll be having commercial farming and people will move out of agriculture. So, if you want an inclusive development, we must begin to think about how we break out these dynasties of poverty through qualitative but accessible education and health. If the poor doesn't have that, if it doesn't have the skills, and therefore to have the capacity to be able to participate in the production process, it will not be able to share in the result of the output. You will continue to have the gap widening and widening and widening. So the issue of inclusiveness is not going to happen, because you're not just going to employ somebody for the sake of employing somebody. You employ somebody because he can add value to what you are doing. The idea that a poor guy who has nothing doing, no means of livelihood, can, you say it's okay, can have 30 or 40 children with nothing to offer them, and the state doesn't have the resources to give those people the capacity to participate, you are building an army and a time bomb that might consume everyone sooner or later. Again, there is the last point I make here is the broken trust between the government and the people in terms of taxation and services. The people don't want to pay taxes because they don't believe that the government will offer them, and so on. But let's quickly move on. Economy and the opportunity. It is said that necessity is the mother of invention. And I want to talk about, I've talked about the gloomy parts of this. But it's important to provide that context, because we're not going to talk about how you move sustainably without dealing with these other ones. This is an opportunity now to actualize the 54-year-old aspiration of Nigeria since the 1962 development plan for diversified and sustainable economy. It's an opportunity for us to escape the oil and rentier consumption economy towards production.